Hi students, let's continue with this Turing machine. Now coming to the Turing thesis. So in the previous videos I explained how the tape is working and what is the basic formal definition of the Turing machine. Now let's see the thesis on this. The Turing thesis. The Turing thesis states that any computation that can be carried out by mechanical means can be performed by some Turing machine. So what it is saying? The thesis is saying that whatever the computation, the calculations that you are doing, that can be carried out by mechanical means, and it can be performed by some Turing machine. So these arguments for accepting this theory, I want to accept this theory. Means the computation that can be carried out by mechanical means can be performed by some Turing machine. So I have the arguments on this for accepting this thesis or anything that can be done on existing digital computer can also be done on by Turing machine. So whatever the argument on this accepting for this thesis is, anything that can be done on existing digital computer. Suppose you are having any digital computer and you are doing some work on that digital computer. That can also be done in the Turing machine. So this is the one point that you have to be remember that. Means see how much, how efficient this Turing machine is. It is anything that can be done on existing digital computer. It is, can also be done in Turing machine. So this is how efficient when compared to the digital computer, the Turing machine is also the efficient. And here, no one has yet been able to suggest a problem solvable by what we considered on algorithms for which a Turing machine program cannot be written. Okay, so no one has yet been able to suggest, they are not able to suggest also a problem that is solved by considering an algorithm. By considering any algorithm, you solve some problem, but no one has yet been suggested for which Turing machine program cannot be written. Okay, this is also one argument. And another argument here is the language that is accepted by a Turing machine is recursively enumerable language. That we already said in the definition. Whatever the language that is accepted by the Turing machine is recursively enumerable language. Here a language and sigma is said to be recursively. Okay. It is said to be recursively enumerable if there exists a Turing machine and that accepts it. Okay. So when you can say that the language is recursively. Okay. Recursive means here. A recursive means nothing but replacing same set of rules for any number of times. We are recursively means we are just replacing the same set of rules any number of times. Then what about the enumerable? Enumerable means nothing but the list of elements. Okay. So the language that is accepted by the Turing machine is recursively enumerable language. So that is what is that recursively enumerable? It's nothing but it is a language L and sigma, that is the input symbol, is said to be recursively enumerable if there exists a Turing machine, that Turing machine has to be accepted. Okay, so this is the Turing machine thesis. Thank you.